Of course, joining him is Vikas Singh. He is the popular author of Bhima, The Big Fix. He's previously co-authored The Know of Things with Derek O'Brien. And Jag Saraiya has now assisted Amish in writing this one. We welcome you, Vikas. And the man, oh my God, what do I mean, how do I even introduce him? He needs no introduction. So, he has taken it upon himself, just like Amish Tripathi, that he is going to deliver a hit every year. There is a common thing between Amish Tripathi and Varun Dhawan. They play in millions. Millions of fans who love Amish's work. Millions of people who love Varun Dhawan. And after his previous hit, oh my God, I had to bow down to him. Varun Dhawan, can we have you on stage, please? Seriously. Let's hear it for Amish Tripathi, Vikas Singh, Varun Dhawan. Could I please request you to please unveil this? The cover of... Okay, अब ये जो बुक हमने कवर रिवील कर दिया है, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू अमीश, यार इसमें शक्ल दिख रही है. नॉर्मली when we see अमीश त्रिपाठी's books, they're all like silhouettes, like some nice muscular animated stuff.
He's muscular too, yeah.
Full on, and we get to see his face. Yeah, so tell us about this cover first.
Normally, my covers don't have the face. Yes, right. The face is usually hidden. That's because, I mean, they're normally of gods and goddesses. So I'd like people to have their own imagination. One of the benefits of having a book as compared to a movie is the readers fill in their own imagination into what I describe. But he's you know, he's a historical figure, 1,000 years ago. So I thought maybe we'll show his face. And there are, of course, like in all my books, there are hidden symbolism, etc. So you can see on the horse, there's a Trishul out here. He was a Shaivite. This is a shivling, small shivling that he used to wear. That's the flag of Bahraich. On the spine, there is a, I don't know the spines here. Is there? Okay. So there's a coin out there with a map of India. So there's a lot of hidden symbolism across.
Trust Amish Tripathi to get all these symbolisms and perfection into even the cover. We love it, don't we? Can we hear it? For the amazing Indic Chronicles ka pehla bhaag, this is.
Thank you.
Varun, we all are Amish Tripathi fans. Yeah, so what is your first reaction to this?
First reaction, I would just say, first of all, a big good evening to everyone who's over here. And it gives me great honor and privilege to be here and launch this book. I remember being a big fan of Amish when the Shiva trilogy came out, and I read Maluha for the first time. I was like very intrigued. I was like, who is this writer and how is he's written about Lord Shiva? And I love the take, and just when you read about it and you read the landscape of how he described the world, you know, your imagination just runs wild. And at that moment, because I'm an actor, I'm like, when can we make a movie like that? When can, you know, can I play a part like that? Oh, am I too short to play this? All this went through my mind at that point. And I never thought that I'll be called to launch a book of his ever. But this is a great honor, honestly. And just the backdrop of the book, when I spoke to Amish and Amish told me, you know, this is the book. It's about India's first Dalit king. I was so fascinated by it. And in history, when you read about the caste system, you read about how our country has evolved and stuff like that, how we dealt with the caste system then. It's. I think he's one of the most relevant writers of our time. He's someone who's so popular with the millennial crowd, and not only the millennial crowd. I think people from all around the world. So actually, we should all feel proud that we have an Indian writer who's making headlines all across the globe.
And I completely maintain that history was not my favorite subject in school, you know. But because of Amish Tripathi, I want to go back and write my papers, and maybe they should include Amish Tripathi's books in the syllabus, because that makes history damn interesting. But I'm going to move towards your right, Amish. You are going to introduce him to everybody who's looking at him for that.
I will. Vikas is my partner in crime for this. One of the problems for me is I have more story ideas than the capacity to write. Takes me a year and a half between books. And, you know, so there was an idea that what if I can get someone to help me to assist, because I have all these story ideas. I have nearly 20 story ideas in this historical fiction space. And I thought I'm going to, you know, take them to my cremation pyre. And fortunately, this idea has come up. It came from my publisher that how about if I actually work with someone else, share my story idea, first draft comes up, then I work on it. Essentially what it does, expands my capacity, and this is my great partner in crime who helped this first book come
up. Almost both of you are like twins right now. Same height also.
I have a little more hair. But Vikas is absolutely brilliant, and for the first book in this, which is called the Indic Chronicles, the idea is to explore, ignore heroes. Heroes and heroines that we should know about, but they've been ignored in our history books. All of us should discover stories like this. Like if you think of the story of Suheldev, it is such an inspiring story. He was, a prince of a small principality, a backward caste, and at a time when foreign invaders, the invaders from Ghazni, were coming in, and most old Indian kingdoms, they'd all given up. And this man raised an army. He stood up to fight the invaders. He raised an army of Indian upper caste, Indian Muslims, Indian Buddhists, all different castes and creed, raised an army and fought the invaders of Ghazni, the army of
Mahmud. He basically united the
country. United them. He did the biggest thing, that he united us, raised a fantastic army and defeated the foreign invaders. It's such an inspiring story. I don't know why it's not a part of our history books, but I hope this becomes well known across India. And many stories like this, the aim is to bring it out and to let people know Completely. These great heroes on whose shoulders we stand today.
Coin a term which is called Amishpedia. Yeah, because Amishpedia se aisi kahaniyan nikalti hai that we don't know about.
You know, ek cheez main nahi samajhta ye jo kahani hai kyunki hum log film line mein kaam karte hai. Aapko kahaniyan milti kahan se? Jab aap R&D karte ho, to ye online search karte ho aap ya
Google it?
Kaun si history book mein aapko ye kahaniyan mil rahi hai jo hamare writers ya hame nahi mil rahi hai?
Acha, but before that, if I will answer it.
Because you can answer this question.
Either of you can answer this.
Okay, this one Amish can answer, but I just wanted to add a little to what he said. So, you know, basically, I've known him for many years, but this was the first time we got a chance to work together. And I'm audible, right? At the back?
Yeah.
Thank you. So, you know, he sat down, he narrated the idea to me, and of course, I was completely fascinated. And then we sat and we fleshed out the characters and we discussed it in some detail. And he said, okay, now write the first draft. And I wrote the first draft and I was pretty pleased by how it came out. And then Amish started on it. And you know, when I saw the second draft, it was transformed. I mean, he'd kept the first draft, but he had just added drama and philosophy and suspense and so much more. So, you know, let me just say that maybe I created a skeleton, but he put the skin, the muscles, and most importantly, the heart in it.
My friend and partner in crime. Yeah.
Completely. Was he also your partner in cream biscuits? So fun fact, people who are Amish Tripathi fans, you must know that Amish, whenever he writes his books, he says, I'm off sugar. So every time he meets me, he's like, Sangeeta, I'm off sugar. I'm having jaggery and all. We have these discussions. And he's like, but when I write a book, I have to have cream biscuits. And I'm like, dude, how? So how many cream biscuits went into this? Are any brand people listening? You can actually sign Amish Tripathi for this.
Yeah, at various lit fests, I actually have readers who come with packets of cream biscuits and say, ye lo aur jaldi likho. But I will write, I'll answer his thing. You know, one of the things with our history, I'm a lover of, I love reading. My mother is here, my family is here, my kid, Neil. Neil, say hi.
Hey.
Neil, this is Varun. Can I say uncle or dada?
Just Varun.
Okay.
You actually asked him that question.
We all read a lot. We love reading. And actually, many of these books are available. Sadly, they're not a part of our history syllabuses. And there are fantastic stories like this, you know, that like Rajen Chola, for example, you know, one of the greatest conquerors India has ever seen. Conquered most of South India, most of East India, most of Southeast Asia. He's reduced to 2 lines in our history books. You know, the first Indian to defeat a European conqueror, the Portuguese, was actually an Indian woman, a queen called Rani Abakka. It's a fantastic story. I plan to write that story down. Airbrushed out of our history books. There's so many great heroes and heroines like this. We really need to bring those stories out, you know, so that we can celebrate. You know, what a kick-ass country we are, man.
Definitely need to celebrate. I think it's time we celebrate our Indian heroes and we don't have to look to the West or look to any other countries to get, you know, because I also get this a lot, that you get inspired by the West, you get inspired by the West. And you, yes, you do, because they put it out nicely. But I think when we have writers like Amish and Vikas, who are doing such a great job in making our history more accessible and entertaining, I think it's high time that the reach of his books will not only be limited to reading. I'm sure we'll soon, hopefully, see a very well-made adaptation which can travel the world.
Thank you so much, Varun, Amish, Vikas. This was brilliant. Thank you so much, media, for being so patient. And let's remind you, your book is releasing 23rd of July. You can pre-order it. And thanks. Hopefully, it's not raining. So. Yeah, it's going to be a lovely evening.
And if I can add my gratefulness, deep gratefulness to Varun for coming for this. I'm, you know, he's kind and his manners. I mean, I was so touched when I spoke to him. Brilliant guy.
You're giving me the book before it releases, no?
Yeah, 100%.